Hello, I'm Becky Bagley, Director of the Nurse Midwifery Education Program at East Carolina University College of Nursing. The video you are about to see is a demonstration of delayed cord clamping in both a vaginal as well as a cesarean birth. I hope you'll be able to use this video to implement delayed cord clamping in your institution. We are at a cesarean birth of a 28-week baby. The NICU team is present and has been told ahead of time that the OB is going to wait 30 seconds before clamping and cutting the umbilical cord. Up to half of this baby's blood volume is still circulating within the placenta at birth, and if we wait a minimum of 30 seconds after delivery before clamping the cord, the baby will auto-transfuse 30 to 40 cc's of this blood, which will help to decrease hypovolemia and the need for blood transfusions in the NICU. If this baby was term, the delay in cord clamping may be extended up to 120 seconds. There are some contraindications to delayed cord clamping, such as multiple gestation, major congenital anomalies, RH incompatibility, isoimmunization, placental disruption, such as abruption or cutting through the placenta, meconium-stained amniotic fluid, the need for immediate resuscitation, such as decreased tone, central cyanosis, or apnea despite drying, as well as at the discretion of the OB or the NICU provider.
A little bit of pressure.
This baby is less than 29 weeks gestation, so the OB is placing the baby in the polyethylene bag to prevent hypothermia. The room should also be warm to 78 to 80 degrees. The nurse is using a stopwatch to call out the time every 10 seconds.
All right. Ready to clamp?
20 seconds.
During the 30-second delay, the OB may provide stimulation for the baby to breathe while evaluating its response.
Right.
30 seconds. All right, clamping
cord. Notice how the baby is cradled between the mother's legs while waiting the 30 seconds.
All right, cord is cut. And we're coming to NICU. Can you place the bulb right there? Thank you. Coming to you guys. There we go.
NICU now has the baby and will take over the resuscitation.
We're going to deliver your placenta now, Melissa. You're going to feel a lot of pushing, all right? There we go. We're going to need some cord gases on this. And I'll give you the placenta here in a minute. All right, placenta is out. I'm going to hang the pit. All right, Melissa, how are you doing?
We are in the delivery room waiting for the birth of a 32-week baby. The NICU team is present and has been told ahead of time that the OB is going to wait 30 seconds before clamping and cutting the umbilical cord.
Big push. Good. All right. Head's delivered. Take a deep breath. Push again. All right. He is out.
Notice how the baby is held below the level of the placenta. This helps transfuse the blood more quickly. If this baby was term, the delay in cord clamping may be extended up to 120 seconds, and the baby would be placed skin to skin on the mother's abdomen.
NICU, do you mind coming and taking a look here?
Notice how a member of the NICU team is invited to come evaluate the baby. The nurse is using a stopwatch to call out the time every 10 seconds.
30 seconds.
Okay, we're clamped. And we're clamping again. And we're cutting. All right. And we'll take the baby on over.
NICU now has the baby and will take over the resuscitation. There are some contraindications to delayed cord clamping, such as multiple gestation, major congenital anomalies, RH incompatibility, isoimmunization, placental abruption, meconium-stained amniotic fluid, and the need for immediate resuscitation, which includes decreased tone, central cyanosis, and apnea despite drying, as well as at the discretion of the OB or the NICU provider.